say howdy. Well, now this here is a story about the Rock Island Line. See, the Rock Island Line's an old train that runs from Illinois down into New Orleans. Now, if you're hauling certain things on board, when you get down into New Orleans, you got to pay the man some toll at the toll booth.
I hate that toll.
Fella pulled his train up down at the toll booth, stuck his head out and said, "Hey, boy, what you got on your train?" And he said, "I got livestock, I got livestock, I got cows, I got pigs, got sheep, I got mules, got all livestock, I got all livestock, I got all livestock." He said, "Are you all right then?" He said, "I thought you might be hauling some of that old pig iron." He said, "What in the world is pig iron?" He said, "Man, that's what we're calling hot hubcaps today." He said, "There was a bankers convention in Moline, Illinois. Bunch of bankers been taking money out of farmers' pockets. Had a big convention. Somebody stole all the hubcaps off their car." He said, "That wouldn't be me." He said, "Well, you all right then, boy?" So he started picking up a little speed to get on through the toll booth. He went, the toll booth. He looked back. He said, "Hey, boy, I fooled you. I got a train full of hot hubcaps off bankers that stole money out of farmers' pockets." He said, "Well, you all right then. Have a good trip on the Rock Island Line." "Well, I fooled you. I fooled you. I got big iron. Got big iron. Got all big iron. I got all big iron. I got all big iron." Yeah. The Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. Rock Island Line is a road to ride. Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. If you ride, you gotta ride it like you finally get your ticket at the station for the Rock Island Line. Cloudy in the west, looking like a rain. Round the curve, come a passenger train. Northbound train and a southbound track. She's already leaving, but she won't be back. Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. Rock Island Line is a road to ride. Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. If you ride, you gotta ride it like you find it. Get your ticket in the station for the Rock Island Line. Go ahead! The engineer said, "Before he died, two more drinks that I'd like to try." Conductor said, "What could they be? A hot cup of coffee and a cold glass of tea." Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. Rock Island Line is a road to ride. Rock Island Line is a mighty good road. If you ride, you gotta ride it like you're finding it. You're taking the station for the Rock Island Line.
We have our own personal hero here today, one of the cornerstones of country music, one of the cornerstones of American music. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, my man, Eugene, the Shelby, North Carolina Flash himself. How about a hand for Earl Scruggs, ladies and gentlemen? I said Shelby.
That's close.
Come on in here. I said Shelby, it's more like Flint Hill, ain't it?
They're pretty close together.
Pretty close together.
Yeah.
Honor to have you here, sir.
It's a pleasure to be here. Glad to see all the folks in the studio, too.
Yes, sir. Well, I got your picture on the wall over there, and it'll be here every show, because if it hadn't been for you, we wouldn't be doing a TV show right now. That's the truth. Let's play John Henry the Steel Driver, man. Thank you. talk like that, Joe. Yes, sir. What about that Earl Scruggs, huh? Yes, sir. Earl, there's a fellow over here I'd like to introduce. My favorite time of the week when I was a young'un growing up in Mississippi was sitting with my daddy on Saturday afternoons to watch y'all on TV. That's my daddy John, that's my mama Hilda. How about a hand for my folks over there? Thank you.
He was about 13 years old too, wasn't he?
Yeah, at least. And I tell you what else. My wife Connie said the first time she ever saw country music was on your TV show. So why don't we get Connie out here to sing a song with us right now? Hello, Connie Smith, ladies and gentlemen. Where are you, baby? Oh yeah. There's Earl.
It's an honor to be standing on the stage with you, Mr. Scruggs. This is a great old Carter family song called "Storms Are on the Ocean."
Thank you, Earl. Thank you, Connie. Well, I introduced you to the fabulous superlatives a few minutes ago. We're going to put the Apostle Paul. Somebody said, why do you call him the Apostle Paul? Well, he's got a 1,000-watt smile hooked up to 1,000,000 watts worth of talent, and he plays the bass and sings in a righteous manner. Here it comes. Apostle, are you ready? The Bluegrass Express. A 1, 2, 3.
Riding the Bluegrass Express, riding the Bluegrass Express. This train will soon be gone, and I'm going home on the Bluegrass Express. She crossed the river at Newport Town, Louisville, Lexington, she's southbound, Richmond, Winchester, Bowling. Express, riding the Bluegrass Express. This train will soon be gone, and I'm going home on the Bluegrass Express. This train will soon be gone, and I'm going home on the Bluegrass Express. On the Bluegrass
Friends, say hello to Mr. Jason Carter, if you would, from the Dale McCurry Band. We appreciate you moonlighting on Dale and the boys. They'll be on our show in just a few weeks. But I've never got you in anything bad, have I?
No,
never
sir.
Told you wrong.
No,
well, I'm about to put you into something that's going to change your life for the better. A little country culture here. The Goodlettsville Flash, the most popular man in country music, the king of country music. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a hand for the old Tennessee Slicker, Leroy Troy? How about a hand for Leroy? Where is he? Come on. Come on. See there. Hello, Leroy. What's the good word from Goodlettsville, son?
Well, the good word from Goodlettsville, I guess, is old Leroy gets to get out of the house this morning.
Well, pick one for us. What you got on your mind?
All right. I like your shoes, Eddie.
A lot of cows died for those.
Yeah, I'll say. Here's one called My Rabbit Dog.
Yes, sir.
Gareth C. We'll give Jason a break, too.
All righty.
Here we go. Finest rabbit dog in Middle Tennessee.
Well,
the greatest name in all these parts since General Robert Lee. He hit the ground a running when he was 3 weeks old. First thing he found for me was a big old pot of gold. He was the greatest time I've ever known. Now Leroy Troy's rabbit dog is gone, gone, gone.
Wait a minute.
Shotgun, Gilly spied a rabbit and he got him on the run. He's chasing through the country, chasing through the town.
Right.
They lit across the ridge and now they're heaven bound. He was the greatest time I've ever known. Now Leroy Troy's rabbit dog is gone, gone, gone. Come on, Jason.
Jason.
I saw a wheel of fire turning way up in the sky. When I saw what it was, I began to realize Gilly Dog was on the trail of Zeke's wheel of sparks, running for a rabbit on the deck of Noah's Ark.
All right.
He was the greatest time that I've ever known.
Woo.
Now Leroy Troy's rabbit dog is gone, gone, gone. dog is gone, 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 gone.
Yes! Big doings.
Thank you. All right.
Here, Roy.
Once my soul was astray from the heavenly way, I was wretched and blind as could be, till my Savior in love looked down from above, and he reached down his hand for me. When the Savior reached down for me, when he reached down his hand for me, I was lost and undone, without God or his Son. When he reached down his hand for me, when the Savior reached down for me, when he reached way down for me, I was lost and undone, without God or his Son. When he reached down his hand,
thanks again for coming, Earl.
My pleasure. My pleasure.
It's an honor to have you here. Don't know that we ought to end the show without the national anthem. Would you lay into it for us? Foggy Mountain Breakdown, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much.